Yo, what's good? What's up? It's your boy Chris Bit, the drummer boy. I want to say a quick shout out to all of you guys, my fans. Thanks for watching my previous video. Thanks for always showing me love. And those of you who go a step ahead of some people to say shout out to me, to like tell me, okay, we love what you're doing. Thanks so much. You guys are the reason why I do this stuff I'm doing. And in my last video, in my last tutorial video, I was talking about this other song I produced that you guys, the other songs I produced that you guys want me to make a tutorial video for. You know, I was getting a lot of emails. You know, people thanking me for doing the last video, and you know, I got a whole lot of response from you guys. Thanks to you guys. If you're one of those people who like to come and peek and go without subscribing, without liking, without leaving a comment in the section below, don't do that. You know, feel free to like. You know, you never can tell. Like, subscribe, hit the subscribe button now if you haven't done so. But if you have, so today I will be talking about one of my favorite productions from Chris Beat himself. You know, that guy, that crazy guy that with the good looking face and all, you know. So I'll be talking about Temper featuring Burna Boy. That is Scales and Burna Boy. You know, one of my favorites of all time. Of all time, you never know, but one of my favorites right now. So the song, what I had in my mind when I wanted to make the beat, not the song, because there's a whole lot of history with the way the song came about. What I wanted to achieve with the beat was a cool song, a cool. My mind was not on Afrobeat whatsoever. I don't have any fella influence whatsoever. No, I didn't have. It wasn't on my mind when I wanted to make the sound. I just wanted something cool, calm, with just the piano and probably some synths playing around. You know, this was the highlight of the song for me then. This, what's wrong? Oh, sorry. Okay, so for me, the song was basically all I wanted in the all I wa or the only thing I wanted to sound distinct in the song was basically this sound. You know, I wanted this sound to come from beginning to the end, you know. So sent it to Scales. I didn't record him though. I sent the song to him. He did it in a studio and he sent it back to me. That I was like, whoa, are you kidding? Blah blah blah. So I had to like go back and retouch some stuffs, move some stuffs back and forth and all. You know, if you're in the business, you know how it is already. So I will pretty much take you into the journey of how I made it from scratch to like a level where you can make it too. So if you have your laptop, get ready. You should get a laptop, connect your headphones to it so you can. Let's make it together. So you play whatever I'm playing. Thank you. So this song, the tempo is at 100. That's the BPM or whatever you want to call it. The tempo is at 100 and I started with this here. Yeah, you can hear the tempo here. You can hear the metronome here. Don't ever start your beat without your metronome on. It's very dangerous. You might mess things up, you know. So always your metronome and whatever you. The sound, remember what I said, the sound should be in your head. So I have my metronome on like this. So I have my metronome on like this. So I have. You go. So I did something like this. After having this groove on, you know, I went ahead and added this. You know, that's we have a groove already. So it was immediately, you know, remember I told you I don't like to start my beat. Remember I said I don't like to start my beat with the melody so I don't get stuck. I don't know, it might be the melody for you, but me, if I start with the melody, I tend to like play a few things and I might not like the groove. I might, you know, people will be like, it's cool. But then if you make a beat that people are saying it's cool and you don't really think is your thing, you know, I've done stuff like that. And people will be like, bro, what are you doing? This beat is mad. This beat is, but to me, I'm like, duh, this is not me. You know what I mean? So I have it. I have the snare and a particular percussion from Logic, actually. So the snare is actually my snare. And after that, I added this. That's the popular Chris beat, what would I call it? The popular Chris beat bounce. So with this together. With the snare, you get. So we have three instruments making sounds now, three. So after this, we might decide to like throw the piano in, you know, to like give us that emotional feel, you know, happy. I call it happy music, you know, give you the happy sound to it. Like, so. So after you have your piano, you don't want to mess up your frequency. It's very dangerous. It's like turning your girl off and, yeah, sorry. It's like turning your girl on and like doing the, saying something that will make her just get off the bed. You know, if you're too young to understand, that's you're on your own. So after like doing all these things, you know, see your beats like your girl, you know, you want to treat her nice. You don't want to let her shout too much. You don't want to bring her breakfast in bed, you know, all the sweet, so sexy. You want to take her out. You want to make sure she's well dressed. You know, when people see you, you know, you want people to address you with the way your girl. You want people to address your girl with the way she looks. You know what I mean? So, same thing with your beat. You want people to see you through your beat. You want to dress for you. You want to make up, you know, you want your beat to have Mary Kay and all. So you spend expensive stuff on your beat. So it's same thing. It's the same thing with this. This sound now, you can, listening to the sound and you hear it's Chris B, the drummer boy. You can picture who Chris B, the drummer boy is. Chris B, the drummer boy is that guy that, you know, probably owns a 3 million era watch, you know. Did I mess it up? You know, you probably imagine, once you hear the sound, you're probably thinking of, okay, Chris, when you hear it's Chris B, the drummer boy on the sound, you're probably thinking about that guy that owns a 3 million era watch, that you know, slays, that looks like an artist, and it's just, some say he's just the producer, you know. I say he's not just the producer, it's that guy that creates music. You know, that guy that loves to see people dance. I believe we can connect to people with the kind of sounds we make, you know what I mean? So, yeah, back to the babe-ish. So, after this, I gave her this. So having done all this, the next thing that I wanted the next sound I wanted to have inside this thing is the groove, you know, like the bass. I wanted something to go like, I wanted, but then I tried that, I wasn't really feeling it, so I just decided to go for the, what's this thing called? The every one count, boom, 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 boom. Just so it moves along with the metronome, because it's sounding good. It's sounding better with the metronome than the stuff I added. You know, the metronome is going like 1, 2, 3, go. 1, 2, 3, go. 1. But then I added, no, I didn't want that. So I went for the 1, 2, 3, go. 1, 2, 3, go. 1, 2, 3, go. You get it. So there you have it. And after adding the kick, okay, another thing that is very important when you are making this sound is this. There's one like a crash that comes in the beginning. The crash sounds like this. This one. Very important, you know. It's like calling people's attention to the song, like bang. You know, if you've seen any Nigerian movie where the town crier comes and brings a news from the king or something, goes like that's bang. So everybody tends to listen. They want to know what's going on. Who's this? Who's this? Who's that? Ah, it's Chris with the drummer. But they'll be like, oh, that guy. So yeah, you want to use this if you are doing it, and if you are making the beat with me, are you progressing? If you are, comments right now. Let me know you're progressing. So yeah, we have this. Oh, sorry, I forgot to mention that I'm using Reason and Logic together as my DAW. You could use anything. You could use Ableton, Fruity Loops, anything, Sonar, Studio One, anything, basically. Just apply the same techniques, you get it. So. Trust me, this is the whole of the song there. Just imagine this part looped from like beginning to the end. You know, I looped it, I sent it to the client, and the client did his part, sent it back to me. I now had to like adjust, okay, take away some stuffs here, add some stuffs, but I'll show you all that here now. So this, I looped this part. Let me count how many instruments we have. So you know what I'm talking about when I say you don't choke your babe. You know, you don't want to give her everything and make complain later that she's too fat. You don't want to do that. So you want to keep her sexy. And if you like fat girls, you know, you still want your fat girls to like remain, you know. Sorry, I'm using girls today. That's just the easiest way to explain, you know. I believe most of you guys are male, you know. But if we have females too, it's good, you know. Enjoy yourself. You know, if for females too, you don't want to make your guys just that fat guy who can't really give you what you need, you know what I mean? So give you what you need in the sense that, you know, just you want something, you know, on the good side. So you have this. So what I did basically was I went ahead and added, I looped this part. This part came for like 12 bar, I think. Okay, we have 4, 4, 4. Here, okay, here. Okay, yeah. The first snare I used, that's this snare. It's actually my snare from one of my sound pack that is coming out really soon. To the guys that have been buzzing me saying they couldn't get the sound pack, we had an issue posting it on our site. Don't worry, by the time this one is out, you probably have them already. I used this from my sound pack. You get it. This one. It's actually from Logic Pro X orchestral kit, you know. And same thing with this other one. This one. I this is just like a clap that I filtered the whole low and I added a reverb to it. Pretty simple. Then the piano. It's actually a grand piano from Nexus 2. A grand piano from Nexus 2. This. It's like using a sine wave, but it's from Electra from Tone 2. Yes. So altogether the sound, I think that's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They sound like this. You know, that's like the whole song there. So I looped this part for like 1, 2, 3. That's like 12 bar. After the 12 bar, I have this break. You know, so the sound continues again. Let me bring in the vocals from here so you understand what I'm saying. That's without this is without the kick. I'm just trying to explain to you that the song that's pretty much the whole song before. Fuck. I'm just trying to explain to you that's the whole song. Like, I just looped it and it played all through. Sometimes simplicity is the key. Sometimes, not all the time. Sometimes you need to go hard and, like, you know, let them know you got the stuff in you. So nothing changed from like the first part, from like the first bar to this one. Nothing. It was just everything. It was still the same thing. It was just a loop to this part. To this part. That's part. So what did I do? I did a backup with a brass. Is it a brass now from Nexus? Yes, a brass from Nexus 2, like this. You know that. I added that to like just spice it up. That, and that's where the whole thing came from. If you listen to the original song, this is the remix. If you listen to the original song, there's nothing like this. It was just a straight, no loop, nothing. It was just a straight looped track and bumpy, you know. So the remix, you know, it's a remix. I had to like switch things up, add some things to it and change so it don't sound like the original song, just different vocals. So people won't say you're lazy, you know. So the brass is the only thing that's changed. Then after that, I'm getting people for shita. You know, I still use the same brass to respond to what Skills was saying. I'm getting people for shita. I'm getting people for shita. I'm getting fine senorita. Okay. They call me Young Dangote. Na na na. Hello, hater. Nice to meet you. Okay, yeah, in this song, this is not a pom-pom sound, but in this song, the famous pom-pom sound is in it as well. I get people for Shita. So, okay, after this whole thing, I needed to like give it that Western feel. So the only way I could give it the Western feel is to break everything down and have a rise, you get, and create like a rise so people anticipate the sound more again. So I did that here. For the less, have a good time. So how I achieved that was that I took a bass from Nexus. Let me see the name of the bass. Okay, basic triangle. A basic triangle bass is like it's like this. Sounds like this. So it sounds like this originally. And remember what I said about not trying to like choke your sound with the wrong frequencies. So, you know, this is already sounding too full, you know, and fat. I brought in a Fuzwa from Logic. So to cut some low frequencies and give it that wah. You know, the instrument is the instrument, and the name of the thing sounds like what he does is a wah, like foo's wah. So he adds that wah sound. I feel stupid, but you get it anyway. It takes out that he adds that wah sound, and I filtered the whole low frequency with auto filter here. So the auto filter is doing this. And the fool's wah is doing this. You know. Yeah, so you can do that. Then another thing I did is, okay. This software is pretty much old. FabFilter Twin. I added FabFilter Twin. There's a preset called the Grittered DJM. DJM for DJ Mixer, I don't know. So that, I added that with a little bit of delay. Cut off the low frequency again because I already have something that has a low in the song. So I don't want my frequencies to clash, so you won't curse me or do anything when you're listening to the song. So it sounds like this. So it sounds like that together with the bass thing I had earlier. Let's see how it sounds. With the break, I added a breakdown. I call it a breakdown. You get it in my pack too. This sounds like this. You know, calls attention to let people know that, yo, something is coming. Then this same instrument, I reversed it to create the rise. Genius, yeah? Yeah, I know. So this one, you know, it sounds like, here, if I reverse it, it will sound like. So, it's the same thing. So, yeah, this is it. And in reverse, it sounds like this. Yeah. So, all together, let's see how it sounds. You know, then we went straight ahead to what was coming. In the mindset of the listeners, the rise creates something. I don't know how it happens, but it just does. If you listen to EDMs or just basically any electronic music, you know, where they have that breakdown, before the rise, before the highlight of the song, you know, it creates something in the heart of the listeners, like, okay, something big is coming, you know. Sometimes you have your stuff going like, you have something going like. So they are waiting like, okay, what's coming? Then you hit them, you know, with unexpected stuff, you know, just like Chris B would do it or anybody would do it, you know. So, yeah. So I came back with the loop, with the same loop we've been coming from. That's from the beginning. I brought it back. That's everything apart from the little stunt. They call it stunt. You know, Skill said, Chris, just do, you know, stunt like at the end of the beat so that people just have a different feel, you know, since we're saying like almost the same thing we said in the original song, just some few changes. So I added this. This is the only place I added like a sign base, you know, to back the piano up. I didn't use nothing like that, and if you still play it in the club, it's still bumpy. Like, you know, to create that bounce, bang, bang, so I did that for the outro. You know, one thing about making sounds, beats, basically, is to keep your groove. You know, you don't want your listeners to be tired. You want to give them one interesting thing from the beginning. Maybe the intro, you give them something, and you create like a bridge, you know, a rise in the song so that people expect another thing. And with me, you know, if you are really a fan of Chris B, you know, before an artist does anything on the beat, before anything, you are already carried away with the stuff you are listening to. My beat is like telling you a story. Oh, okay, how I met this girl. Okay, oh, how I went to school, how I did this, how I did that. The beat is actually telling you a story, you know. It might be a love story to you. It might be another thing to you, you know. Seeing me tells you a story, you know what I mean? So I did that, and I added another. I used the same brass we used earlier to do this. You know, this sound was actually from a movie I saw that night, one Mexican movie. So there was a bounce they were using. If I do this now and do something like this. So the the Mexican feel to. But then we're talking about Afrobeat here, not Espanol. So, sorry, I got carried away a bit. So, what am I saying? I fused that into the sound, so it gives me whatever feel it gives me. So, I don't know. You decide. You know. Oh, I forgot some of us were making the. I told some of us to like bring out their laptops to like make the beat. All you need to do is just see the video over and over again. I'm sure you get it one way or the other. Your headphones, very important. Be seen and try to make what you're hearing. So after doing that, a muted trumpet came in here. You know, to calm the whole thing down after all the gbagudugba and the gbagudugba on it. Go. Remember, there's always something you're trying to let your music do before the artist comes to do anything on your beat. Your beat is already telling you, your beat is already telling people or telling the artist what you actually wanted the song to sound like, you know. This beat for me now, gives me some sort of vibe that I can't just explain it. It's just the vibe, you know. It's just the wave for me, you know, being the king of new wave. I'm not saying this to brag, but I'm saying it to like motivate you out there to understand that if you are going to make sound, make sure you make the kind of sound that in the future you'll be proud to tell your kids, you know, how you did this, how you did that. I'm pretty young, and I know most of y'all watching this video will be young folks like me, you know. I love it when young people like myself are making crazy stuff, you know, try to like go outside the box, try to make. Sometimes I make sound with my generator sound. You know, if you live in Nigeria, you know what a generator means. A generator is what it means. What is a generator? So sometimes I move close to my generator to like record sound, to create some sort of sound, some sort of vibe for myself. You know, I put it into Reason. Don't worry, for y'all, for most of you guys doing stuff, messaging us on the academic stuff, which is on my website. You could go there. I'm sure it's showing right now, www.chrisb.com here. Just click and, you know, subscribe, send us messages. We'll get to you. Let me know another video you want me to make. And if I've not been able to get back to you, you guys sending me messages and all, thank you so much. My name is Chris Beat. I love you guys so much. Thanks for all the messages. Thanks for the love. Like, subscribe, comments. Feel free to tell me what you think I'm doing wrong or what you think I should add to this stuff. Thank you so much. You're the reason I do this. Love you guys. King of New Wave, say so. Brah.